has just joined us about a year ago.
Yeah.
About a year ago, he joined Toastmasters, another Toastmasters club, many years back, and has stopped for a couple of years. And he had actually found that the training in Toastmaster has given him a lot of benefit and can take him further. And he, that's the reason why he's coming back to Toastmasters. Currently, he is a financial planner, having his own business, and he is our club public relation, vice president public relation. With him around as our public relation member, we have got a lot of communication publicized internally within our club members and externally to other clubs as well. And you can see his, if you go to Facebook, you go to our website, you can see a lot of things that he is publishing for us. This evening, his speech project number 8, Getting Comfortable with Visual Aids, he will deliver the story of success. I believe he will tell you all about the success of his journey. Let's put your hands together to welcome Chia.
Selling. Anyone in the past or current that you are in the sales profession? Can I have a raise of hand?
Once again?
Anyone sales actually in the sales profession?
Was.
Was also, you can raise your hand. So, thank you. Definitely this topic actually appeals to most of our audience. Sales, something that I very afraid of 3 years ago. Especially when being approached by, especially when we go for shopping mall, we have those booths asking whether do you like to buy, right? Apply for credit card, or to invest in certain products, or to buy an insurance policy. Those are very common. But 3 years back, I joined the industry. Many people thought that selling is just about talking, but the effective salesperson is not about talking, it's about listening. That's why in Expert Toastmaster we have listening evaluation session. So why do I choose this topic? Selling. It's not just about people that working in the network marketing or in the sales industry, but it's appeal to everyone, even in Toastmaster. How Agnes appealed by the word love what you do. That's why she came for the meeting. And some of us, especially when you talk to your boss, you actually have to sell yourself before, otherwise you will not get the pay rise or promotion. And also for kids, especially, I'm not sure whether you still remember when you were young, you always ask your mom, dad, can I have this? Dad, can I have that? Can I buy that? Or can I? But sometimes your dad or mom did not give in because never learned the art of selling. Selling is an art whereby when you go for booth, many people try to sell you things that may not be necessarily what you want. Selling should not be. Consumers are now very intelligent. They no longer buy whatever they're not required. They actually do research. They need to know your profile. Even like joining a Toastmaster, they will go to our blogspot, Facebook, we have DTM, before they're deciding whether to join our club. Especially at Store, we have more than half. Since 1999, we have 2 DTM. Of course, that gives us the branding of how we attract new members. And selling is not about the product. Selling is about yourself. You know why when some people ask you, most of the time you will say yes. It's because of their charisma. If Jeannie asks me, can you be an evaluator or can you be a role player? Most of the time I say yes. Yeah, it's because of the attraction. You have the brand that you actually portray to other people. It's about yourself. Each one of us have our own brand. It's how you sell yourself. Be it in your work, be it with your wife, in a relationship. This art of selling is very important. It's something that I need to learn from our senior member, those in relationship for more than 20 years or 30 years. Especially to sell to your wife sometimes is not so easy.
Yes.
If you have been married, yeah, you know what I mean. When a woman say, ask you to listen to them, but then sometimes ask you for response. So sometimes in the dilemma whether shall I give response or should I be quiet? My wife told me, how come no response? Means what? So I was puzzled. I thought I should be listening more rather than giving response. So I was caught in dilemma. That's why Toastmaster helped me a lot.
Yeah.
And in selling, people buy you. In my services, people buy me. It's not about the product. It's about the trust that people have in me or people have in you. I'm sure last time when Yuki was doing sales, selling cars,
yes,
people actually buy from Yuki, not about the car. Okay? That differentiates Yuki and the rest of other person. Like David, why people attracted to follow and to listen to him as a mentor? It's because he has a brand that she actually helpful in order to help those new members in learning about more about Toastmaster. So it's about the person, it's not about the product. So love, logic versus emotional. Do you think that selling is emotional? Or buying is it emotional?
Yes,
in a survey there is 80% is actually people buy due to emotion. Especially when the new Huawei phone being launched. Why be that? People are so emotional. I want to get the latest gadget in town. Then you will use logic to support your emotional buying decision. For example, last time, when I was working in Cycle and Carriage, all my colleagues were driving Mercedes LAC class. Parking beside them, the emotional appeal. I'm driving a Proton Saga, emotional. How come working in the Cycle and Carriage, I'm driving a local car? So you will try to upgrade yourself. Emotional, you are saying that, oh, local car is not good. Why not I upgrade myself? Before driving a Germany car, I bought a Vios. So upgrading myself is an emotional appeal. Then I justify by the logic. Oh, my car is very old. I send every month, I send for service. It costs me that much. That is the logic. Then I'm saying to my wife, doesn't matter, 1,000 per month, I can pay that. But you have the emotional, you actually decided, then you use logic to support that. Yeah, most of us. I'm sure in the advertising industry, people know that our weakness is on emotion. That's why the more advertisement that you see, the more extol Facebook appear on Facebook, then you will tend to like our page. And then you will try to join us as guests, and then, hopefully one day you will be attracted by the learning experience of the club. So selling is not something that you do to someone, but it's something that you do for someone. That means you need to know that to do something for your prospect, for your customer, know their needs. Without further ado, I would like to pass back the control back to our Toastmaster.